everyone, my name's Sophie and I've just finished my third year doing maths and secondary teaching and I have a job lined up for September, what's really exciting. Basically I'm just here today to tell you a bit about my course that I do, my teaching course, and a bit about the education department in general, hopefully giving you a bit more information in choosing the right course and university for you. So first of all, I just need to tell you why I came to university. So I've always wanted to be a teacher, and as you well know, if you're looking into doing teaching, you'll need a PGCE or a QTS. Now I could have done a maths degree and then gone a PGC to become a maths teacher, but instead at Edge Hill I did a 3-year course where I got my maths degree and my teaching degree in one. So that was, I thought, was the best decision for me. So it's just 3 years instead of the 4. It also meant as well I've been on a placement every single year. So in all the teaching courses, whether it's secondary or primary school teaching, you get a placement every year, which is really good because you get 3 different schools to go to. There's a lot of variety. I was in a behaviour school, I was in a mainstream school, loads of different things, so you get a lot of experience, and this obviously is going to really help me when I come to September. So I'm not just chucked in the deep end. In the first year it's a lot of observation placement, watching other teachers, getting a lot of tips and stuff. In your second year you're teaching half a timetable, and then in my final year, what I've just completed, was doing 75% of the timetable. So it's just kind of building you up, getting you used to what it's going to be like when you're actually teaching, what I thought was really helpful. With regards to like assessments and stuff like that, because I was doing maths, I actually have exams for my maths. So I had exams and coursework to gain my maths degree, basically. And what's also good as well, if I don't want to go into teaching, I've still got that maths degree at the end of the day, as well as my QTS. So I have my exams for that, and then with regards to your teaching element, you have a couple of essays to do, and then you get assessed on your placement, so how you're doing your placement, your mentors, comments and feedback, and then they recommend you for a QTS. So slightly different for primary school, they have no exams, lucky them, they've got a lot of coursework and essays, and again they get judged and graded on their placement. There's loads and loads of support within the education department. Before we even went to placement, we had contact with schools where they come in and tell us a bit about planning and making lessons and stuff. So you've got a lot of support. Also, we're all in one department as well. So if you needed any of your teachers, any of your mentors, any information and help, you can either email them, they get back to you straight away, or just go to the education department on campus. Everyone's normally in there in their offices. So it's all in one place, what's really good. And then you get to meet a lot of other people on different courses while you're there as well. Especially with primary school and secondary, you are with other people as well. So I was with the English secondary people, same with primary ed. If you take different majors and minors, you move different people. So it's a good way to meet more people on your course. What else is there? Why Edge Hill, you might be thinking, there's a lot of other universities that do teaching. However, I chose Edge Hill because it's really well known for teaching. A lot of employees look at Edge Hill for the graduates they come from there. They email some of our tutors to see if they've got any people that they can send to them. It means it's got a really, really high employment rate after you graduated, hence why I've got a job in September. Well, it's obviously really exciting. And if you are looking into teaching, that is one thing that you really want to have a look at. So there's different ways you can get into teaching. I did have a look at being like a teaching assistant or different other avenues to get into it. However, I thought this was the best one coming to university. One, because you gain such a wealth of knowledge from people who have already been in the industry and ex-teachers, which is really good. But also the amount of placement and experience you get is really, really valuable. So I hope I've answered a couple more questions that you have. Just a bit about my course really, some of the exams, what we do, our placements, and hopefully it's informed you a little bit more about your choices and why you might want to come to Edge Hill. I definitely recommend, if you're looking to apply, go online, have a look at the course, research it a lot, look what you'll be doing, what modules you'll be doing, especially if it's a specialised course like Maths, English, or Science RE, have a look and see if it's the certain modules that it's going to be covering and they're the ones that you want to do. I definitely recommend your personal statement. Get a bit of experience beforehand if you can. For example, go into your old primary school, go into your old high school, and then you can put that on your personal statement to say that you're proactively already looking to do it, and it just shows your enthusiasm into wanting to become a teacher. And just try and sell yourself, really. Why would Edge Hill want you? Why do you want to come to Edge Hill? Hopefully this helps, and thanks, bye.